No, it's the older film.
For this exhibition on anxiety, we're really excited to have a guest curator, Gwendolyn Zabicki, who's put together this wonderful painting exhibition that really highlights how different artists, different people are dealing with this constant low-grade anxiety that many of us feel in our everyday life.
The title for On Anxiety came from Fear and Trembling from Soren Kierkegaard, who wrote beautifully about anxiety and how it permeates everything that we do. The artists in this exhibition, I think, are confronting anxiety through the act of painting. And I would say that they fall into one of three categories. They're feeling anxious about family and personal relationships. Their anxiety comes from financial or career-related decisions, and also health and well-being. The composition of a lot of these paintings produces anxiety. Specifically, Celeste Rapone's painting features a woman holding a knife dangerously close to her eye. The painting itself, the composition, evokes anxiety. Brandi Twiley grew up in rural Oklahoma. When she was a young kid, her childhood home burned to the ground. Brandi's paintings in this exhibition are made from school portraits of her siblings and herself. The portraits look damaged because they were. There's smoke damage and moisture damage, and she recreated that fire damage in the paintings. The paintings themselves, there's something really haunting and sad about them. The children themselves look sad. They're not the typical, like, smiling, beaming self-portraits. Brandi and her siblings were aware of being different at school. I think it all is reflected in their expressions. There is a lot of figuration in this show, and I believe painters are returning to figurative work. Figuration is so relatable and it's so eye-catching. It really grabs you. The return to figuration, I think, comes in several ways. Sometimes it's playful. Sometimes it's hard realism. And I think the artists in this exhibition experiment with a variety of styles.
I've been aware of her work as a curator and artist in Chicago. She presented this proposal to the gallery. It was really clear to me that this would be a great match and a great opportunity, not only to do a project with her, but also with some of the amazing artists in the show.
Really, I'm trying to curate the shows that I wish someone else would curate. And the shows that I do are very painting heavy. Gender parity is very important, and all of the shows I curate are at least 50% female artists. And it's not something that I set out to do intentionally, but that just happened organically. There's so many talented female artists working right now that it's almost impossible not to curate a show that's at least half women.
The Cleve Carney Gallery, we're always trying to continue our tradition, highlighting prominent and important female contemporary artists. So it just really made sense with someone with the kind of awareness and vision of Gwen to bring her in to continue to add to our tradition.
I hope that students will come in and see this show and identify with not just the work, but also the styles of painting, and to find inspiration and see work that they can look at and say, oh, I want to make paintings like that. Or to say, I didn't know you could make paintings like that. I didn't know that I could make personal paintings about my own life and that other people would care and want to see them.